Hello, I'm Katie Freeman with Freeman Furnishings, and in today's video, this is really all about a learning experience for me. This video is about how not to make a resin and wood light. I'm gonna walk you through the mistakes I made, lessons I learned, hopefully to help you out in the future. So go ahead, grab a drink, sit back, relax, and enjoy. From sapling to heirloom, every piece has a story, and it's our job to share that story. All right, so this project really got started because I had acquired these three spalted oak cookies that had the hollowed out center, and I figured they'd be perfect for making resin and wood lights, where the center I would fill with somewhat translucent resin and then be able to shine a light up through it and make just a really nice light that would create a nice low glow. So in order to make it be a light and stand on its own, I did start with using my miter saw to kind of cut off the end to make it stand up. And then I went ahead and started with using painter's tape on one side to seal it off so that I could pour the resin in. This was my initial thought. I have pretty much almost always, up to this point, used just painter's tape when I'm dealing with a hollow cavity and a piece of wood instead of making a whole mold. I went with using Ecopoxy liquid plastic for this pour. And for this initial pour, I did a 2-to-1 mix ratio, so two parts. And I wanted to create originally a center kind of swirly mix with using this glow-in-the-dark gel that I purchased from Michaels, and then just regular blue tint that's also from Ecopoxy. So as I started to pour, I realized that the tape was not holding up, so I had like a full, basically 5 liters of resin leak out as I was pouring. It created a huge mess. So, alright, I need to do a better job of sealing it. Clearly, the tape is not going to work. I did have to let the resin, though, like fully cure onto the piece of wood too before I could do another pour. And you see here, I first started with hot glue to try to glue it down to a piece of melamine. The glue did not stick, and so then I went with a clear silicone, and that did stick. I put clear silicone on the bottom to stick it to the melamine, and then around the outside too, so that if it did leak out, it wasn't gonna leak like fully out. So while you're watching this part here, I just wanted to let you know that Freeman Furnishings has a Patreon page where you can become a patron to support not only this channel and means of sharing content, but also vlog and podcast, and get extra content just by being a patron, plus goodies and swag like stickers and t-shirts and all kinds of fun stuff. If you are interested in that, go ahead and check out patreon.com/Freeman Furnishings. And as always, no pressure. And then back to mixing up the resin. Again, I am using the 2-to-1 ratio, 2 parts, part A, 1 part, part B. And still trying to do the whole glow in the dark medium with the blue tinted medium. And so I'm pouring it in. And just so you know, these cookies are about 4 inches thick, so it's going to be a 4-inch thick pour. My intent had been, with the 2-to-1 ratio, it's about 36 hour cure time, so my intent had been to come back at about 18 hours and do some mixing to get some swirls in for the pattern. However, when I came back 18 hours later, the resin was cracked. Basically, it had overheated when it was curing, and so it cured super fast, obviously in 18 hours or less, and it had totally cracked. I'm not gonna lie, at this point, I pretty much wanted to throw this thing across the room. It just felt like everything with this project that could go wrong was going wrong. So I contacted Ecopoxy to find out what I had done wrong. And at that point in time is when I learned that the 2-to-1 ratio liquid plastic can only be poured up to 3 inches deep. And like I said, these cookies are about 4 inches thick. So the pour was approximately 4 inches, and that's why it cured super quickly and overheated, and that's why I got the cracks. So I now know that if I need to do a pour over 3 inches, I can still use the liquid plastic, but I need to do a 1-to-1 ratio, which has a 72-hour cure time on it. It just means I have to be more patient and waiting for the cure. I did not decide to chip out all of the resin. I decided to keep it and go with it. Again, because it had cured so quickly, I didn't have time to come in and swirl it and get any kind of pattern with the resin. So all of the resin that had the glow and the dark gel in it sank to the bottom, and so one side has, it does kind of have like a bluish greenish white look to it, almost to me like icebergs. So I did go ahead and carve it to shape. I wanted to thin out the top, and so that's what I did. I used my King Arthur's Tools attachments for my angle grinder. So I used the Lancelot and the Holy Galahad. I also used the small grinder, the Merlin 2, to get the shape that I wanted and to get it sanded. I did apply just directly to the one side where all the gel had kind of sunk, more gel just on top of it. And then once that had dried, I sealed both sanded sides of the resin with a very thin layer of Ecopoxy UV epoxy. And this is meant to be done in a very thin layer, so it was perfect for this application. Now, I did still want to shine a light up through it, and so I just purchased a light that's really in like an LED puck from IKEA, and I drilled a hole in the bottom for the light to shine up through, and I finished the whole piece with spray on lacquer. So that's the process of how not to make a resin and wood light, but these are all great lessons learned, and I know how to apply them to the other two spalted oat cookies that I have around and available, and I hope to make another one of these and have it turn out just the way I am expecting. Alright, so if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, hit the subscribe button down below so that you can get notifications for when I have a new video that comes out, whether it's wood and resin or some other kind of funky experiment that I am working on. I hope you enjoy, and I will see you next time.